So we're sitting here in this backyard exactly 10 years from the first time I came to New Orleans to film you guys, the South Riders, Diversion 3.0. Since then, there's been like a whole string of events of you trying to make like Flatland history.
I didn't think you were coming, but then you showed up. So, no, I mean, back then, like, it's hard for me to remember back then because now it's just like, you film something, it comes out. And, you know, back then it was more like, you really put your time into what you were gonna do riding-wise if someone was filming a DVD because of the fact that you knew that people had to wait to see it. And that you knew it was going to be more like they were going to have a copy in hand. So back then, I definitely took filming, I approached filming in a different way than I do now.
I was so stoked to just come to sit at home, learn tricks, and then come back and show Mickey and Eugene what I learned. So that was like, that was my hype for riding.
And that hyped me up because it felt like we was on the same page, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, he understands too what's going on with Flatland.
Just a passionate group of dudes. I'm sure every little scene is passionate about why they started riding and why their group is such a tight-knit group of guys. But with us, we're just like, you know, when we get on the phone or when we meet up in the lot, it was more about, I can't believe we're here now. I can't believe it's because of riding bikes that it brought us together to do this trick, to learn this thing, to, you know, it's always been a very passionate, like, deep-hearted thing that Flatland's been in our hearts. Someone was coming down to document what we had going on, so we were gonna spill our thoughts, and that's why it came out like that.
Oh, we got some neighbors.
Got neighbors over here.
What's up?
I made history with this dude right here.
Are you making a video?
Oh yeah.
I'm messing with you.
No, I made history with this dude. We're recapping what happened.
Come on now.
10 years of making DVDs, man. Yeah, sold worldwide, son.
Can't stop it.
One of the craziest scenes to ever go down was the rain scene. Mm-hmm. The water was like peg high at times. Mm-hmm. And you were like still doing like blenders and stuff.
I was just like young and motivated to try to do whatever I could to get in front of the camera. Uh-huh. You know, like, oh, if there was rain, I'm gonna try to ride in the rain. If there was a hill, I'm gonna try to ride up the hill. Uh-huh. You know, something that you normally don't see in a Flatland video. I was kind of motivated to try to get out there and do it, whether it might have been a little silly at some times.
Yeah.
Obviously, that's not how someone's gonna ride.
Yeah.
But I knew that it was gonna create a cool image, or I hoped it would, you know.
I'm sure it scuped a lot of people out when they seen that.
Rain scene, yeah. I'm still getting messages on Facebook about the rain
scene. No way.
Yeah.
It was crazy. How do you not slip off those pegs, dude? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the craziest part.
Those were good pegs.
Oh, alright.
Yeah, I mean, it was a grippy ground.
Uh-huh.
The tires were gripping, so it's not like I was on a real slick surface.
Uh-huh.
But, actually, I think the trick in there that I was most stoked on was just the half packer to CrossFit hitchhiker.
Yes.
But since I had just learned it, that was the one thing that my feet was slipping on because the pegs were real slippery.
Yeah.
And I had just learned it.
Yeah.
So after I actually pulled it, I was like, there is no reason for me to ever mess this trick up again since I did it with my pegs wet, you know.
Right. So I guess the secret to riding in the rain is grippy ground, good pegs.
And baggy jeans, because those jeans were real baggy.
Oh yeah. 2003.
What was that all about? I had to throw down because it felt bad because you come here and it was raining, flying all the way from California to shoot a Flatland video, and it's pouring down rain. You can't leave empty handed.
It's funny because a lot of times I have an idea,
mm-hmm.
and I think that it's just going to be real, real easy. Like, oh, I'm gonna do this, uh-huh. I'm gonna do that, and then I get out there, and it's actually way harder than what I thought. So that's kind of what happened.
Like, yeah.
Even though I did wind up pedaling up the hill really far, sometimes it was really hard to get that thing started.
Oh not another one of these.
I wasn't thinking the fact that some of these hills are gonna be so steep, it would be impossible to kind of time machine into it.
Yeah.
So I remember I was falling a lot. I remember you and Mickey holding up my legs, like trying to get me going.
That whole thing took two trips, P, or whatever.
Oh, it was on two separate trips.
Yeah, two I separate trips flew, you yeah. came out. And then it was like, you make
told,
sure
you
make
told
sure
me
you
bring,
the same clothes.
Bring those clothes, uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, I remember just hurt. I remember being sore after all that.
Yeah, dude.
Trying to pedal up those hills and stuff.
You crashed pretty hard a couple times.
Oh!
I think you said something like, if I go away from this walk and I didn't work hard enough.
Definitely.
Yeah, something like that.
Flatland's not supposed to be in the dirt or uphill or on an incline. It's ridiculous. It really is.
I remember Mickey being on the phone with Nicole, being your assistant.
4.0 has taken birth. 4.0, Diversion. In the process right now, Nicole.
Yeah, and back then I wasn't really too concerned about what people thought as far as like I kind of had to take that out of my mind as far as like, man, this, you know, some people out there might think, oh, that ain't Flatland, this dude's just riding a bike up a hill. But again, it was like I thought to myself, how crazy would it look if this dude's on the top of another hill, looking down at another hill, and I'm riding my bike almost like a road, like a cyclist or something, like someone in a race or something. So the point of it was to make it kind of look unreal, to kind of do something for the beginning of that that issue of Diversion. I think I was motivated back then because I knew like what we're doing now is gonna come in packaging. It's gonna it's gonna be a sealed wrap. It's gonna be a DVD. People aren't gonna know what's in it until they open it.
Yeah,
it's just a different day these days.
Yeah,
with,
it's a different era back
then. You know, you can go and click and find a video real quick.
Mm-hmm.
We could go film another blender scene right now and have it online in 30 minutes.
Yeah, exactly right.
Yo, Carter, what's this?
I thought it was.
So yeah, let's do J-Lo.
J-Lo. Rolling. How did you get that, dude?
It was Macy's/Hot Wheels, I think. Jennifer Lopez was there for her new line of clothes.
Yeah.
I think there was some other celebrities there too.
I was in the middle of all this paparazzi stuff. I was like, wait a minute, man. Like, Flatland video in the middle of like paparazzi.
It's cool to sometimes bring Flatland to like something that has a red carpet.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
know, like, you know, a lot of times Flatland's not in the spotlight, but when it gets to be in the mix of something like that, you know, you got to take full advantage of it and try to weasel your way in, you know. Jennifer Lopez was like, you know, right in the front row, and I remember you were like, dude, when you do your time machine, make sure to do it right in front of Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, you went right to the edge of that stage and like,
I kind of looked
at the pedal time machine.
I looked for her when I rode to the end of the stage, where she at, where she at. Not that J-Lo, not that Jennifer Lopez cares about Flatland, but I was hoping.
She did for that second, dude. For that 1 second, her whole focus was on you, front and center, doing that pedal time machine.
Yeah.
And she was stoked.
I think back then was the moment that I realized that like, you can take Flatland anywhere. The moment I realized I could film beside an ocean with a beautiful background was the same moment I realized that I could, you know, ride in a windstorm, you know, and make it look cool. As long as the background was there and the surface was flat, I always took it as an opportunity to, in my opinion, try to make Flatland look a little bit more appealing to the eye, to maybe someone that wasn't interested in it.
I'm trying to expand who can see Flatland and making them stoked on it, even if they don't ride.
Yeah, it wasn't really about the hardest tricks.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't about like the hardest moves I could do on a bike. It was more about like trying to take Flatland somewhere where it's never been before. Now it seems like it's getting harder and harder to find stuff to do.
Yeah.
But I'm still got a little idea book and I'm putting stuff down, you know. The goal is always to make Flatland look dope, you know? And some may argue with me that, oh, Flatland looks dope anyway. And it does, I completely agree. But, you know, I just think it's awesome. that Flatland is something that you can put into a unique background and make it look even better than what it looks normally. So I'll just end by saying thanks for taking the time out to make all the trips you did around the world, not just to film me, but to film all the other Flatland riders on the planet and capture their stories. Those DVDs made a big impact in the world of Flatland, so thank you.
Ew. Thank you.
All right.
So it's been about 7 years since I've been in front of this Diversion lens right here. I'm real stoked to get a clip, and this one's for the riders.